it reveals a lot about how her character, how Rollins deals with the whole therapy world. You know, it's she's doing it because she suspects she needs to be there, but actually doing the work in the therapy sessions, I think she finds very tough.
But you did want to go elsewhere in episode 8. We dream of machine elves. Mm-hmm. You were willing to go with Adler and go to another dimension.
Right.
And so it is in you to kind of dig in, right?
Right, right. I think the guide is much different, you know, in Adler and in my therapist.
You think Adler is a more fun approach?
I don't know. I think, you know, she's less beholden to him and to finding, it's more out of curiosity and finding answers to her questions rather than uncovering some uncomfortable things in her life and revealing why she does some things she does. I think that's a little more uncomfortable for her.
And then prior to that, you're talking about your relationship with Carisi, and you're kind of tiptoeing around that too, which the doctor's trying to pull out of you.
But, yeah.
And I was thinking that here you are in therapy, and then this whole thing goes down, and you get kidnapped.
I know.
I was like, she's never going back to therapy.
I know, exactly.
They ruined it for you.
Exactly.
So when you're reading on the page that she's talking about you in therapy, what are you thinking is going to be happening with Carisi and Rollins? You're not in that scene, but you're aware of it, obviously.
Right.
At the read-through. Does your mind start working, or do you try and guess where it's going, or do you...
Not really try to guess where it's going, but just kind of what the meaning is and to kind of divine what the writer's intentions are for putting that in, because that kind of... Even though, obviously, I don't hear that, I don't know that, but I think it's kind of informative in the world in which we are. And then you kind of see how Carisi reacts once she's been kidnapped, particularly in the follow-up episode. You know what I mean? I think it just speaks to this relationship that they have is complicated. It's kind of ambiguous and as to what the meanings are, but it's clear that it's not just like, oh, we're buddies, or in passing, but it's not necessarily the other thing. It's just it's a fraught... relationship, and I think that kind of clues me into it when I read that in the script.
Obviously, you know that the fans are really pushing for this to happen.
Right.
Is all that in your head, or?
Well, I think there's some things, like, let's say it did happen, then you instantly lose the mystery of it and the tension of it, and it becomes another tension of, like, how do you work? And I think that's a lot less interesting, you know what I mean? I feel like a lot of the whole Rollins-Carisi thing, it's not because we've had a ton of scenes where we're, like, dealing with it. I think it's a lot of just people inferring and reading in between the lines and what's not said. And I think that's what's really cool and interesting
about it. That is very cool.
And it makes it deeper and more meaningful that it is this kind of unspoken thing, you know what I mean? And you can see in the characters' emotional attachments to each other as opposed to scenes that are, like, you know, here's them doing this together or that. And I just find that more interesting now, you know, what you can say, like, with a look as opposed to a whole storyline about it, you know? Mm-hmm.
Is that similar to your take on
it? Yeah, and I know for myself, and I can probably speak for you as well, like, we just kind of respect it, the relationship. So for us to say, you know, oh, are they or aren't they, you know, like, it's interesting, but we respect what's going on, and sometimes... I think the writers respond to what they're inferring and what they're seeing, you know, on an unspoken basis, you know, between mine and Peter's character on screen.
Yeah.
And, like, when Rollins has important moments, there is Carisi. And so they give us those opportunities to, you know, like, your best friend and you don't have to say a lot, you know? Yeah. And it's really great to have those moments on a TV show where everything is bang, 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 next plot, next, you know, next point, next point, next point. It's nice to, like, sit in with a friend and just be like, this sucks.
Right.
You know, or this is awesome, you know, like, can you come over? I just had a baby and, you know, and, like, let's celebrate.
Yeah. You know? I think there's kind of, like I've said this a few other times, but it's really been a relationship that's grown organically out of the show. I don't think the intention was ever that, okay, these two are going to have this kind of, you know, intensely close relationship, whatever that means. But that just kind of organically grew out of, I think, me and Kelly. And, you know, I love Kelly as an actor and a friend. And I think that translates onto the screen. But I think it's cool because we have this, I feel like there is a private life of Rollins and Carisi that kind of exists outside of the show. Mm-hmm. And that there's, like, a lot there. And I think there is, Carisi can be a version of himself, or a more open version of himself, I think, with Rollins in a way that he's not with other people. And I think that's a very, very close relationship that's It's awesome to have.